نور في الظلمات أنسي في خلواتي يا سعدي وهنائي القرآن حياتي
نور ملأ القلب ففاض بحب كتاب الله
أشرق دربي بالقرآن فشكرا يا ربا
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We all dream of one thing more than anything else. That's the paradise. That's one thing we all strive for so hard. Every one of us, all Muslims, in fact, many non-Muslims too. We talk about paradise. We know in Arabic it means Jannah. But what exactly does the Quran mean when it says paradise and when it says Jannah? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mean when he's describing the paradise to us? Let's have a look at the meaning of the word Jannah in the language of the Quran, so we can appreciate and grasp the greatness of paradise, such that maybe it will motivate us more to go for paradise. Arabic language, as we know, is very deep in its meaning, comprehensive, vast. Let's go and have a look at the root verb, the three-letter root verb of the word for paradise in Arabic. The word for paradise, of course, is Jannah, Jim, Noon, Ta, circular Ta. However, its three-letter root is just Jannah, Jim, Noon, Noon. What does that word mean? The three-letter root for the word Jannah, paradise, it actually means, would you believe, it actually means to conceal and hide and veil something. Imagine there's something great behind me and there's something to hide it and conceal it. And that's one of the meanings of the verb Jannah, to hide and to conceal. Another meaning of Jannah that flows from then, follows on from there, is to shield and shelter you from something. So something might be there to harm you, to hurt you, and you take a shield, like the shield in the olden days when you're fighting with your sword and a shield. So you have your shield and you use the shield to keep something away. Again, to protect you, to conceal you, keep something away, to hide you, conceal you from the blow that's going to harm you. So this is the root meaning of the verb for paradise in Arabic, meaning to conceal, to veil, hide something behind. That's Jannah. From there, the Arabs used it for different meaning, which will help us to understand fully, or at least better, what paradise means. One of the usages of the word Jannah that the Arabs used it for is to describe what I was referring to before, is Junnatun, Junnah, with the Dhamma on Jeen. Junnah in Arabic is a shield, what I was referring to just before. So a shield that you take to protect yourself is Jannah. That's what the Arabs used it for on the battlefield. Have a shield to protect yourself and shield yourself, conceal yourself from those blows that might hurt you. The Prophet ﷺ in a hadith used this word Jannah also. And he said to us in an authentic hadith, he said, "As-sawmu Jannah." The fasting, it is a shield. The Prophet ﷺ referred to fasting as a shield, Jannah. Meaning, fasting, when you fast, it develops the taqwa, it develops the self-control. This self-control out of consciousness for Allah, i.e. taqwa, is what helps us to shield us from the hellfire, from the sins and the effect in hellfire, isn't it? Because when we have self-control, we can keep ourselves away from sins, and that will shelter us from the hellfire, shield us from the hellfire. And thus the Prophet ﷺ says that fasting, it is Jannah. See, same root word, Jannah, Jannah. Another usage the Arabs use this same word for is for Jannah. Notice Jannah, Jannah, Jannah all have the same root verb, Jannah, Jim, Noon, Noon. So, the other word the Arabs used it is Jannah. What does Jannah mean? Again, they use the word Jannah, Al-Jinnatu, meaning something like the demons. In English you say demons, but in Arabic we know it best. I'm sure every Muslim knows it because they talk about it all the time, is the jinn. The jinn, those beings that are hidden from us. Jinn, those other living beings like us, but in their own form and character, but they are hidden from our eyesight, concealed from our eyesight, and we cannot see them. So in Arabic language, they refer to them as jinnatu, al-jinnah, jinn, meaning they are concealed from us. Again, the root verb that is used for paradise in all its different usages, it's referring to concealing something from the eyesight, hiding, veiling, shielding. That's what it's referring to. Another word that the Arabs use for it is majnoon. Majnoon is related to al-jinnah, the jinn. The word majnoon means, the Arabs used it to describe somebody who on one hand is possessed by a jinn, there's a jinn hiding concealed inside them, and on the other hand, as a result, their understanding and their mind and their judgment is concealed, and their judgment is concealed from making a proper judgment. Something where the jinn comes inside and possesses them, as a result, they judge very poorly, the better judgment is concealed from them, and as a result, they describe them as crazy. Someone possessed by jinn behaving crazy because they cannot see the better judgment and so on. And the jinn that is hidden and concealed inside them. Majnoon, that's the word they use to describe that. These are some of the usages for the word, for the verb from which comes the word Jannah. Another usage that the Arab used with this verb is the word al-jannatu. Now, al-jannah is the same word for paradise. In Islam, the word al-jannah is used for paradise, but the Arabs used the word al-jannah for a simple, for a broader meaning before, its literal meaning before, and that means al-jannatu, they used it for a garden. Imagine a big, large, beautiful garden, and it is surrounded by tall, lofty, beautiful green trees. So a big garden full of pleasures and surrounded, the pleasures are all hidden by surrounding big lofty green trees or any trees, big trees. The pleasures are hidden by these lofty trees around. Such a garden, the Arabs called it a al-jannatu, al-jannah. The same word Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used it to describe the paradise. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the same word al-jannah, al-jannatu, for that Arabs used it for that garden, that beautiful garden, concealing all its beauties and pleasures by the tall lofty trees around it. Allah used this same al-jannatu concept to describe the paradise. And thus the Prophet ﷺ, he informed us about this paradise, this beautiful garden, which has got so much pleasures inside it. The Prophet ﷺ described it by saying to us that it is مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. These pleasures of the paradise is something that no eye has seen, nor any ears heard. Never has it come to anybody's mind. Meaning, we can see a lot of pleasure around us, but the pleasure of paradise is the ultimate pleasure. It is so great that no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor any mind conceived the ultimate degree of pleasure of paradise. And that pleasure is hidden in that garden, which is what paradise is. That garden that is concealing this incredible pleasure, surrounded by beautiful, tall, lofty trees around it, such that we cannot see it until we get to the paradise. Now we can only hear somewhat about it, but not really the degree, the greatness of paradise. This is the Jannah. Allah describes this paradise in the Qur'an. This Jannah that is concealed, Allah describes it in the Qur'an in Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda by saying, by describing it as فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُم مِّن قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. Allah says, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ. So no soul knows. مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ. That which has been hidden, that which has been hidden for them. مِن قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. From the pleasure, the comfort of the eyes. This is how Allah describes the pleasure of paradise. That garden where that beauty and pleasure is concealed in this life for us now, and with those beautiful trees around. And when we imagine, when we go inside our paradise and discover that beauty that no eye has seen, ear has heard, nor any mind ever conceived. That pleasure, when we see it, how will we be feeling? In order for us to remember all the time that the pleasure of paradise is far greater than what we have ever seen, it makes sense that the word used for it is al-Jannah, that garden that conceals the greatness inside. And it just makes us imagine and look forward to and crave having that greatness of paradise. And I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to all of us. This word al-Jannah is just one example that shows to us that Qur'an, it is so deep in its meaning, full of wisdom, and it, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses words in the Qur'an in a way that He could have used other words for garden, but He used this word so that it describes best what paradise is. Therefore, the more we learn some of these key words in the Qur'an, the more it helps us to get the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Qur'an, and the more it helps us psychologically, spiritually, mentally, to be craving doing good deeds to get to paradise. As a result, we've got two ways where you can benefit from this. Number one is our course that we are doing that is called 13 Life Transforming Quranic Words. 13 Life Transforming Quranic Words. In this course, I'm going to take everyone through 13 words from the Qur'an that are key words in the Qur'an to understanding the full message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These words, we will be looking at the Arabic root of these words. We will be looking at the uses that the Arabs used it for. Then we'll look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself used these words. And we will look at the meaning in Islam of these words and how knowing this deep and comprehensive meaning of these words, how it really boosts our iman and our spirits and gives us that strength to keep going despite the most difficult of challenges in life, to keep going to seek the pleasure of Allah, the paradise and the eternal good. This is our course, 13 Life Transforming Quranic Words. I'd like you to visit this page on our website, hikmahway.com/13lifetransformers. The second way we can uncover some of the deep meanings of the Qur'an is to learn the language of the Qur'an itself. And we have a special course that is called Tears of Joy. Tears of Joy is that beautiful feeling that we will be feeling deep in our hearts, all throughout our body, when we learn the language of the Qur'an, the Arabic language. When we learn the Arabic, then read the Qur'an, reflect on its meaning, understanding the broad meaning of the message of the Qur'an, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can you imagine those tears of joy that will flow from your eyes? How many times would you have heard one of the great imams in the Masjid al-Haram in Mecca, or some other people reciting the Qur'an, and you see their eyes filled with the tears of joy from the reading the message of Allah, understanding it in its original Arabic language. This course that we are offering to learn Arabic language in different length and different format, the course is in different length and different format, but the course is the same, and it is for people in modern life who are busy with modern life to be able to take out some time and learn the Qur'an and fulfill the dream of a lifetime, enjoying for the rest of your life the beautiful message of the Qur'an as those tears of joy roll from your eyes. This was my dream about 20 years ago. This is one of the greatest pleasures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me in my life. And I would like to share this with the rest of you as well. I've been teaching Arabic language now since I learnt it in the Islamic University of Medina about 17 years ago. I've been teaching Arabic language for more than 10 years, and we've got a course that is taken from some of the best courses that are offered in the world, and we will be offering this course to you. As I said, we'll be offering it in different modes, but the course is the same. We call the Tears of Joy, describing the pleasure you will be feeling. I'd like you to visit. As I said, it's one bit of effort that is required from you and a lifetime of pleasure you will gain as a result in return to be able to understand the words of Allah in their original greatness. As I said, that was my greatest dream in my life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to me in the Islamic University of Medina back about 17 years ago, and now you can do it as well. Don't think you can't learn it. I've learned it myself, not being an Arab, and I know how you can learn it as well. Myself and the rest of the team at HikmahWay Institute will be bringing this course to you as well. Please do visit our website and join us as well in this experience. The website is www.hikmahway.com/tearsofjoy. hikmahway.com/tearsofjoy. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fills our hearts with love for His religion, and our eyes flow with the tears of joy from the beautiful message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the deep, the wisdom, the comprehensive meaning that comes from all of this. It will fill our lives and make it a dream coming true as we experience those tears that we've seen from the great Qur'an reciters, and it could actually be you as well. It could be you as well with those beautiful tears, understanding the message of Allah, the wisdom of Allah, the promise of Allah. I hope you will join us in these two courses, Tears of Joy and the 13 Life Transformers. See you soon.
ملأ القلب ففاض بحب كتاب الله أشرق دربي بالقرآن فشكرا يا ربا
شكرا يا ربا
يمحو عتم الليل